you all for taking time to be here. I'm going to share some of experiences with the Akashic Records and also the way it can benefit us, and also lead you into a meditation where you can have an experience with it as well. So that is the most important thing, to have an experience. Like, you know, no matter how much we talk, until you experience it, it's so different as well. So do tell me, like, in the comments, let's keep it interactive as well. If you have any questions, and also, did anyone here have an Akashic reading before, or listen to a meditation, or has been in the Akashic realm before? So it's great to know that way. All right, no, okay. Perfect. Now is good. One reading prior. I'm sure, Nicola, you could have enjoyed that so much and so profound, right? New to this. Okay. Lovely. So as I was saying, I don't know if you heard me. So I'm from India, and then I moved to Ireland. For 18 years we lived there, and then moved to Seattle. Most of my spiritual growth has happened in Ireland. I don't know if you guys are from there or heard about. So it's a place of your spiritual growth, and or as they say, it's the seeds that get germinated there if you're meant to have a soul awakening. So that is how I had my journey being awakened in Ireland. 12 years ago is where I found this journey, after my youngest child's birth and getting into a lot of health issues, and getting help from the alternative therapies like Reiki, meditation, and then into Akashic realms. But all my life I have heard about Akashic readings or Akashic realm. Because of the way the tradition, the culture is where we are always told, like, there is someone who is scribing our life, so be better, good, have good thoughts, so don't lie, or look after yourself and be kind to others as well. So these are some of the things that I was grown up with, and knowing that someone is writing our script, that kind of in a nice way, I was thinking, like, oh, that's interesting. I wonder what they're writing about me right now. What is my future about? And like many people, I always had a curiosity to know about my future. And I used to go for many of those places where they do this with the parrots. In a cage, they would come out and pick a tarot card, and the guy will interpret. But literally, it's a bird that is picking the card out. And when it does, it's amazing. They would say, like, hey, this is your future, but you have to do this. So that always stuck to me, like, you know, hey, no one can predict our future, but they can only give a guidance. And yet we have to live our life. And for me, that was really interesting point, because if I'm prepared for the future, I'm much more strong about it, you know. And then I realized Akashic realm is that place that we can tap into and get to know what's ahead of it and how we can be prepared with. So that is how I began my journey, and practicing it for 8-9 years now, teaching it and loving it. Like, you know, there is so much of information. It's never old, it's never boring. So take a step back here. So Akashic realm is a place, not literally a physical place, but a place where it has all the information about your soul. When I say about the soul, just not about this lifetime, but also the previous lifetimes we had, and also any other lifetimes we had other than the earth as well. Did anyone of you ever say to yourselves, I don't belong here, I come from a different planet, or you're the black sheep in your home, or now I'm calling like white sheep, because we are becoming more of them who meditate, who do yoga and all that. We are all the different tribe, right? So So when you say that, like you belong to a different place, different planet, it's just not that, but also in reality, it is it, you know, our soul has been from different places. So think about all that experiences are stored in this archival, and we tap into it and bring all the best from there. And this is like time immemorial, like it can go to thousands and millions of years as well. But it's not about accessing everything. It's about accessing what is relevant to me right now. I mean, like, there is no point for me to go back and access what was my cave life in when I have nothing to do with right now. So there is no relevance. But there could be about like, hey, how do I meditate deeply, or how do I connect to the star plans? And what do I need to do? So if I access it, it's much more relevant to my current times, like, you know. And so that is where we go into. It's everywhere. That information is everywhere. You just need to tap in. There are a couple of ways how we can visit that realm. One is by meditation. One is by prayer, which I usually use it. Meditation is very good as well. On my profile, you can see I have a couple of meditations recorded, and people have found it interesting, and also allowing them to experience their own things, which I'll be doing with you guys later. So meditation is definitely a good one, and through a prayer is good, and some people have found it through shamanic healing, or sometimes it's just about that all of a sudden you're doing your dishes, or you're doing something, gardening or something, you just get that like a different experience, you zone out, you get this wisdom, and you just know, you know it. And that is where the Akashic realm information is there, and that is how we tap in. But with meditations and that zoning out, it doesn't happen as much as we want on a regular basis. Sometimes we go there, sometimes we don't go there. But with a prayer or a set way, we always go into that realms and bring that information. Now, anyone can access it because it's our information. We are all gifted and we all can do it. And there is no, hey, I'm not entered into it, I'm not allowed to it. No, there is no such thing as that. But the only thing is, the more we develop our intuitions, the more we bring in connection with our own soul, it gets so easier to access that information. And that is what you need to remember as well. Like, you know, the more you're trusting, the more your intuition is growing, the more, the better the information you're retrieving back as well. Like, yeah. So taking back, like, you know, have you ever been in a situation where you were like suffering from lack of self-love, or doubting yourself, or you're in a relationship not knowing, is this the right one, is this not right one, or a career, like, you know, should I do this, should I not go for this, like, or having a difficulty in a relationship as well, like, yeah, it could be from our parents, it could be siblings, it could be particular manager, it could be a neighbor, any relationships, a pattern that you would have seen on and on, that you have been concerned about it. And some people say that they do feel in, you put a step forward, but you're pulled four steps behind. Like, you know, no matter how much you're putting the effort, you're not getting the best out of it. Like, yeah. So that it could be as well, like, these situations do tell us that the information that we are looking is not right here, but in the soul level that information is. Because when we are going to be born, we made a contract saying, who is going to be part of our family? Who is going to be part of our friend circle? Who is going to be part of our growth? Who is going to come in and teach us the difficult lessons? And who is going to be easier there to support us as well? So these are all the conditions and the contract that we make with each and every one. And we come into the earth. When we come onto the earth, after being born, I think for the generally most of us do forget it, but some children, when we were children, we did remember for about like 4 to 5 years. We did remember, we would have rambled, but depends on like how the parents would have taken in our thoughts, saying like, hey, if someone says like, I have a memory of Australia at like 3-year-old, like, you know, we can say like, oh wow, that's great. Or we would have said like, oh, you must be joking, what do you know about Australia? So it all depends on how we were raised as well. Those memories would have faded, and now we are living that life that we made a contract. And now there has been a million times that I would say like, why did I choose this contract? Like, you know, why did I make it so difficult? Why did I make it so hard on myself? I wish I could have made it so easier. Why did I not choose a much luxurious way like that? I don't have to struggle. But that's only a moment it stays in. And then I realize, oh no, this is much interesting, because life is magical and you just need to go through ups and downs to know the values of everything. And that becomes the interesting part, right? So that is where our Akashic realm, like, you know, the informations and how you get to know your soul contracts. So going back into the soul contract is so, so important. If you're at a crossroads, like, you know, or you have old dramas coming up again and again, and you don't see much solutions coming up, like no matter what you're doing, no matter how you're going to get rid of something, you're not, or a person having a issue with selling their property, it's not going ahead. Like, you know, there could be some ties that are stuck with the people as well, like what's happening here, and why are we not able to get rid of it, and what is our contract to understand it. And once you do that, you get that understanding, things get so easier. Then we are able to navigate ourselves deep inside. It goes, the flow is much easier, that you don't have much hurdles. And you find like, huh, this is not too bad now that I'm understanding. I also say like Akashic place is like a bird's eye eagle, like, you know, where you see life not from the ground floor but from the eagle's eye. You get to see everything, what's happening, so that way you know the matrix about like where you are, what's happening, who is doing what to you, and where you are meant to be, and how you can move through. That makes it easier, right? When you're within the maze, you're lost. It takes time to come out of the maze. But if you're looking through a drone, it's much easier. And you can just come out of it. And it's like, you know, it's raining, you can't change it, but all you can do is be prepared for it by wearing a rain wear or having an umbrella and going out. Like, you know, nobody's stopping us from staying back, like, but you're trying to do the best preparation for it. Sometimes we can change that by being prepared with it, raising our vibrations and not taking in by like giving up and going over and crossing that bridge as well. If you have been on a hike or a trail, or like especially onto the mountain hiking, did you ever feel that you're nearly there and you want to come back, you want to give up, right? But when you just are on the top of that mountain or a hill, you feel, oh my God, I'm glad I didn't miss this, you know, and you so enjoy being there. That little last 10% would have been the hardest, but you're so happy, you're glad you did it. So that makes it easier as well, like, you know, so that is like what gives us the push through the Akashic realms. Since 7-8 years, I have found this, or more than that now, I found easier in navigating through. There are hurdles in my life. There have been traumas, incidences, everything that has happened. But I know I'm not committing to it in a deep way. I know I can come out of it much quicker now. And that is the gift that I'm bringing forward with the Akashic Records, like with so much of a source knowledge, with so much of a guidance. And now this guidance doesn't stay anywhere on the Google or the external platforms. It's within you, your own inner guidance, you tapping into your own Akashic realm. And that is the best way to go into it, like, you know. So think about any of those scenarios that you're ever being, like, you know, or financially as well. Like, why am I working so hard? Why am I not having enough money for my desires or whatever, like, you know, little things, why I don't have it or why I don't keep it, or why is there a betrayal in my relationships, like these kind of things do come up, and they do matter to you. That's the most important thing that you need to acknowledge. It's not about others, but these do matter to you a lot. Some people are very much bugged by the plastics, the environments, the ocean, the sea. And some people are not even bothered about it. Like, you know, so each one of us has a purpose. Have you identified your purpose? Have you identified your life purpose or your soul purpose? That's the most important thing to know about. Once you identify that, once you get an echo of it, it makes it so easier. And also, I'm telling you, like, our life purpose is something that we always knew, but we just need an echo from outside. And then we get a physical proof, like, you know, I always wanted to be a doctor all my life. Like, I didn't know anything else, but I didn't get enough grades to be in that. Then I was chosen the profession of the computers. I did that, and after like 12 years ago, after my child was born, I was drawn into the spirituality and being a healer. Now I do understand. Okay, doctor was the term that I knew, but it's of the service is what I wanted to do. So that has been my sole purpose all my life, you know. But the words might be different because of the growth we are, the place we are in. But it is about, like, what is it at your soul level would have been the passionate thing since you were born that you always were identifying it. Like, you know, it's not a new thing. It's not someone telling you, hey, this is your certificate, go and do it. It's a calling that you get from the soul level, like, you know. So other thing about the Akashic records is you might have heard about Book of Life or Book of Remembrance, right? Or if you were raised like me, if you lie, were you ever told, like, you're going to fry up in the oil, like, you know, when you go into the heaven and hell or whatever it is, right? And this is where the source is, this information. But the whole essence was to keep us on the right path, to be right to ourselves, like, you know, to be kind to ourselves, like, yeah. But this is where the information is there. This is where we all can visit, get the best for our soul and connect back here. Yeah. So does that make sense so far? Type in yes and no or any question, like, you know. Perfect. And every action, every thought, every word we chose are always going to be recorded. And the best part is that makes us shift and be more compassionate, be more kind to ourselves and to everything around as well. And that makes the world a better place. It's not asking someone to make it a better place, but we actually taking a step to make it a better place. And now that is it. Interesting, right? And that is like, why not, like, you know, and how easy it is. And this is a metaphor or a analogy that I always relate to what Akashic records are. By simply thinking about all this information is there, you can't touch, you can't go to a place to open it up. Of course, like, some sacred sites are amazing to channel in easily, but literally you don't need to go anywhere. You can be right where you are and access this information. Just like your phone. Now we all have the smartphones. With the smartphones, you have your data, your pictures, everything stored in, right? And when you have stored all that information, when you lose your phone or your phone drops into the water, the first thing you panic is my data backed up? Like, do I have my data okay there? Like, right? And that's all you were concerned about it. And did you ever visit where your data is backed up? No, never visited. But I know that deep down now, somewhere in the ocean or near the mountains, miles away from where I am right now. And I know I can access it, my data, by having my password. That's all it matters to me. And that's all it's relevant as well. And the same applies to your records. All you need to do is your full name, your birth name, and that's your password to your records, and you can access your information. And that's as simple as that. Like, your soul information is all packaged and in this beautiful space where you need a little key to open those records by your birth name. Yeah. And now some people have the complexity of if they're adopted, or their name was changed, or I know some cultures, they have a different name, but they're called different name as well. So all that will be still valid. You can still access it. There is a way around for all that as well. And the interesting thing is, what can you access? And my question is, what you can't access? Every information is there, like your soul purpose, your life purpose, who you are, what is your past, what is your future, and what kind of a person are you going to be in this lifetime, what are your missions that you'll be doing in this future times as well. Like, you know, it's not about today, but what's ahead as well. Like, yeah, what are your relationships, the inner wounds, like, you know, what has happened there, how do I release a card with someone, like, all the tools, techniques are there as well. Like, you know, repeated patterns, what can I do about it? Or like, if there is a relationship challenge, like, how do I go about it? Now, for me, it's about knowing where our troubled things are. Knowing what I'm looking for a guidance is one thing. The other part is finding a solution, getting the solution, because without the solution, there is nothing we can do about it. And you just like, you're just saying what your problem is, like, keep repeating it for a million times, but unless you get a solution, you can't navigate out of it. And Akashic Records is a place where it gives you the solution, where I know I have tried everything, nothing worked, but hey, let me give a try with what they are saying to me right now, the masters and the lords and the record keepers in the records, and let me follow that guidance, and that is my solution there, and that makes me navigate out of it. Like, yeah. Or if you have any challenges, like the problems that you have, or you're not finding your balance or a peace, or simple as you're trying to meditate and you're not going to going deeper, as some of the people say, it's so peaceful, but I don't feel it. Why is it you're having difficulty with meditations, like, you know, or health issues or allergies? Did you ever notice, actually, you go to a place and all of a sudden you fall sick, and when you come back to your home, you're fine. Again, the location has a healing to be done. Your soul is recognizing that location, that something has happened in the past, and you feel that once your soul is connected. The same happens when you go somewhere and you feel so recharged, and you feel so good, and but when you come back to the home, you're just normal, like, you know, but it's shift in some places happens, or deflate in some places happen. Or there's a connection with your pets. Some people find their pets that you have known them forever, like, you know, and some people say, like, hey, this pet are very new, like, I'm getting used to them, like, yeah. Or phobias, that's other thing, allergies, phobias, like height fear, where is it coming from? Or water fear, where is it coming from? And where is it related to? Like, you know, what has happened in the past as well? We need to know, like, some people find claustrophobic, being stuck in the lift. They just can't, like, you know, and I had a couple of clients. When we opened the records, it turned out this person was like, they were stuck in a cave as they were making out of the cave, and the person couldn't breathe and suffocated and left the life, and that was impacting into this current life. But the moment the person realized it, was made that aware, and now he doesn't have any fear about the lift. He can be okay with it. He just knows he can be surviving okay, and the past need not repeat as well. And that gives you not feeling stuck, but your life force energy moving through as well, like, you know. And those triggers are the fear, the anxiety, or the stress levels will be so shifted. Other thing is reoccurring dreams. Has anyone of you having reoccurring dreams? Think about it, like, you know, why are the dreams coming again and again and again? Dreams always have a meaning, but reoccurring ones have more deep impact. It's like a lifetime that you lived, or something that you are shifting in that's coming up as well. So does that make sense? Like what you can access, there are so much possibilities that we can access. Everything A to Z, like, you know. Here, what if two people have the same name? That's perfectly fine as well. Like, you know, there are so many people having the same names. It's about the intention about whom we are accessing the records with and their specific questions as well. Birthday included. I don't take generally birthdays. Yeah, I just take the birth name. That should be sufficient to open up the records. Yeah, I know some people do it, but it's not really relevant. Written and interpreted dreams since age of 8. Wow, that's great. So the Akashic records are inside of us. Yes, they are inside of us. They are right around us. Like, you know, they are in our energy field. That's the most important thing. Like, yeah. And for me, like connecting to your inner guide, that is the most important thing rather than searching anywhere else. But the thing is, with some information that is within us, the trust is a question, like, you know, do I trust my own information? And if the same information is given by my friend or a counselor, I might take it in a different way, right? I might listen to it. And knowingness and someone else echoing the same thing makes a lot of difference as well. Like, yeah, that makes really interesting. Can you incorrectly close the records at the end? I spooked myself out before thinking I didn't. So if you don't close your records, what happens is you'll feel very lightheaded, spaced out, and because you'll be doing your other third dimension duties, you will feel a bit out of sync and out of balance. So I highly recommend to close out, if you ever open your records, to close out at the end. I always tell my students, like, make sure you have a sticky note in front of you as you open the records, also to have like close your records, like, you know, because you don't want to be driving or lifting off any heavy machineries. That's the most important thing, like protecting yourself as well. Protecting yourself within not having any other energies, like, you know, so that is the most important thing to have. Yeah. And how do you know this thing works? Like, you know, saying I'm a left brain person, I'm into computers, and getting into the spirituality path is not something that I thought or visualized myself when I was younger. But I do remember reading a lot of magazines, books about past lifetimes, reincarnation. I was fascinated. It's not that I needed a proof of it, but I was so fascinated about it. But with the records, I needed a proof, like, you know, hey, does this thing work? Because I grew up knowing it's the monks who are in Himalayas can do it, not a computer professional person can do it. So for that, I had to build a lot of trust in. And so that is where my struggle at the time was, just to test myself. Is this the right place? Like, am I safe here? Can I do this? Like, you know, and so a lot of validations did come in, like, you know, that was so important for me to have the validations. So when I learned this, I did a reading for my husband first thing, because he's my guinea pig. Whenever I do a new healing techniques or anything, I learn. So I did a reading on him. I said some things about his past lifetimes, about him and another teacher that he's in contact with in this lifetime, and how his parents are not accepting it. And then after the reading, he said, that's all right, because this teacher is so good, he shifted my life, but my parents can't accept his energies around. They just can't justify him, like, for no reason. He's so good, but still they can't accept it, because in the past lifetimes they didn't trust him, and that trust issues are still there with them, like, you know. And this thing I never knew about it, like, you know, you're in a relationship, but yet you don't know some of the things because maybe the topic didn't come, or that was not relevant to share with your partner, right? And so that way, that made me, wow, this is spooky, this is cool, like, you know. And and for him, just to understand that, that was enough, like, you know. Now he doesn't make much effort about it, and he just keeps the two parties differently and speaks to them, has a good communication. It just relieved him the pressure that why can't they be together, be nice to each other, like, you know. So that takes a burden off as well for us, yeah. And also the contracts that we make, we can rewrite them. And that's what I started doing it, like, you know, rewriting my contracts related to, like, I had difficulties with speech, like my throat always used to be closed up. I'm an extrovert, but like when it comes to telling my truth, I would struggle. I would have tonsils like a couple of times a year, and came to a stage where the doctor said, you might need a surgery now at this stage, you know, so much of antibiotics back then. And when I did a clearing in the records, it came to one of the past lifetimes. I was choked, and also I was hanged to death, and that brought that fear still there. Whenever I have to speak my truth, I used to have a difficulty. And even now, like, you know, I can speak much easily, but I can't have a scarf or someone touch my. I can have a scarf that I'm comfortable with, but no one can touch my neck. I feel a shock coming in. Even my children wrapping around my neck. No, don't do that, you know. So knowing that, that helped me, like, okay, this is fine. This is coming from the past lifetime. There is nothing that I need to be afraid of. And then I realized a lot of my tribe, healers, they have this feel of something being choking or struggling to speak your truth. And a lot of us were punished for it in our past lifetimes. Even think about the generations that lived through, like, you know, that this work is not accepted, right? That helps as well. And so those kind of validations really shifted me and many experiences. And then when I started doing for my clients, like, you know, what they would say, what they would connect with, like, it was just amazing. Like, yeah, one of the client I would like to share this, it's coming up now. I was doing this reading, it was my early days, and she came in for Akashic reading. And she said, like, why am I having my troubled relation with my uncles? Where is it coming from? And so when I opened the records, this person, in the past lifetime, her dad was backstabbed by his brother, and that made her not to trust any relationships. And now, in this lifetime, she has a trust issue with any of the relationships, in the family relationships, yeah. And now, in the past lifetime, the mother was very close to her, and she gave a protection symbol to her, like a pendant, and that made a connection for them to be very smooth, very thick. And now, sometimes I would, as I channel in, I draw as well. So I drew that pendant for her and showed her. And this lifetime, interestingly, what she said is her dad passed away 2 years ago at the time, and because of some financial issues, he was betrayed by the dad's younger brother, and that's how it has happened. So the past has repeated again. And the mom, because she just got attuned into Reiki at the time, the mom gave a pendant to her, and it was exactly the same. She pulled it out of her handbag, it's exactly the same as what I drew. And now that was a goosebumps, like, you know, and like, wow, this is so deep, like, you know, it can happen. And knowing that, that made her, like, you know, okay, this is coming in from the past, and we asked for the masters to do clearance so it doesn't happen in the next lifetime. And giving that clearance makes your heart open up and to accept the relationships as well. Like, you know, it's not unknowingly some things we do, unknowingly from the past karmic things we do as well. So that is the most important thing, like, you know, and to be aware of it. Kim, a professional does a reading with you. How are we able to access the Akashic Records? So yeah, you can access the Akashic Records through the meditations or through a training or through even, like, you know, setting your intention that you're going into the records. Yeah. How are you connecting with your clients? I do, like, through taking their birth name, and connect into their realm, and also ask them what are the questions they are here for, and that way we explore it further. Have similar experiences. That's interesting. Yeah, you guys can check the profile, so where I have the information about further. And this is really fascinating. I mean, like these tools and tricks we should have had as a children and as a teens, so we wouldn't have made our lives so difficult. We would have made ourselves more belonged quite early on, rather than I waited until my 29th year to figure it out. I wish I didn't have to wait that long, but of course that's what our journeys are to be, right? And so yeah, definitely with the Akashic readings, the life gets easier, the solutions make it much easier as well to flow into. I learned through a couple of masters, and then a lot of practice, lot of deepening my lessons, lot of trial testings as well. That is how I learned, yeah. So how about we go into the records meditation and experience it, and after that I'll share further information, maybe what's coming up to you guys. So if anyone is driving or doing any heavy duty, maybe you can avoid this part or try to relax into a safe place. So one thing I'll ask you is to be open about it. Now, I said so much magical about it. Sometimes they do happen. Sometimes it doesn't happen in the same way. Sometimes it does happen later in our dreams, or in next couple of days, the thoughts might come or things start making sense. And whenever I do this meditation to the group, I always notice that people heal even on the physical side. So do watch out if you have a stiff neck, or back issue, or any discomforts in your physical body, how you are after the meditation as well. So allowing your body to process. So set yourself an intention that you're going to go into your Akashic records and going to see or being shown by your guides and masters anything that you are ready to hear right now. Yeah, you can either sit down or lay down, whichever is comfortable, but I would recommend, if you're used to meditations, lying down is easier so you don't fall asleep. In case you fall asleep, that's still fine as well. Your subconscious mind is processing. I always say in meditation, only three things can happen. One is you go with the flow, or you lose track of it, or you fall asleep, or you remember where I'm taking you with. Let's go on to the journey. Set an intention. So in this journey, we are going to open up your chakras and meet your guides and into the Akashic realm and get a message or a symbol or a word that will make sense to you onto whichever part of your life you are having a little more struggle. Career, relationship, your goals, your location, anything that's coming up to your mind right now. So find a place where you're going to be undisturbed and quiet, and give yourself, yeah, it's perfectly fine if you have just eaten as well, and give yourself that undivided attention, switching off everything that's going to disturb you just for a few more minutes, anchoring into this space. Breathing in and breathing out. Breathing in, going deep into your lower belly, relaxing your shoulders, and breathing out. As you're breathing out, you're loosening up yourself, dropping your attention into your heart, your jaw muscles relaxing, connecting to your heart and your gut, bringing your attention into the soles of your feet, breathing all the way down to the soles of your feet. Visualize thick, deep roots growing down from the soles of your feet, going down into the Mother Earth, deep down, 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 through the layers. And anchoring into the beautiful giant crystal at the core of the Mother Earth. And anchoring you to the present moment and keeping you grounded. And letting that beautiful energy travel back up with your in-breath and out-breath. Pull that up. And letting that energy travel up, 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 up. Through your feet, through the lower chakras, into your legs, through every cell and body muscle. Anchoring you. Letting this energy travel up through your chakras and gently coming into your heart center. As it comes into your heart center is expanding, creating a beautiful infinity sign around your heart center as a protective symbol. Breathe in and letting that energy travel. And now visualize a beautiful column of light coming down, down, down from the source, from the universe. And let this energy travel down into your crown, into your third eye. Feel that tingle, sparkling sensation running down through your spine. And let this energy go down deep. And merging into your heart center. And as it's merging into your heart center, it's expanding and shielding and protecting you. It's causing a beautiful protective pyramid around you. As you go into your records, you're safe and you're protected. Your angels, your guides, your masters, your record keepers, everyone is there welcoming you onto this beautiful journey that you're going to take in. Taking a deep breath. Imagine yourself to be in this beautiful, thick, deep rainforest along with your guides, feeling that energy of the rainforest, feeling connected to the Mother Earth. As you're walking, notice the moss beneath your feet, the comfort, the smell of the pine trees, and also hearing those birds chirping, the waterfalls far behind, you can hear them, and you're walking along. With all your five senses being active, you're noticing everything and you're seeing everything more clearly. It's so vibrant up here. As you're walking deep into the forest, it's like a mystical land. And there you see a beautiful cave coming across. And you're being guided to go into the cave. As you go inside, you do realize it's a deep cave and well-lit cave. You just feel so connected to be here. Your heart lights up being in the cave. You recognize your soul being here before. All that crystalline energy in the cave is illuminating and making you feel surrounded in this beautiful light, safe. As you walk inside the cave, you have your guides, you have your masters, you do recognize some of your spirit guides, some of the spirit animals, or your guardian angels to be there, your loved ones to be there. Just look around who is familiar to you and who is new. And as you walk inside, you do see there is this beautiful place in the cave filled with scrolls and books. It's like a huge library within the cave. And you can see till your eyes end, there are so many books around. Just looking around them, you do notice there is this beautiful book engraved your name with the golden alphabets and letters calling out to be picked. You're being drawn to the energy of this book. Go ahead and place that book into your hands. As you're holding the book, you feel the energy, the lightness, the recharge, knowingness, the connection to the book already. Holding it close to your heart, you look around in the room, and there you notice there is a beautiful place where you can take a seat. Moving over there to the couch, taking a seat and run through the book with your intentions of you're ready to see the information that's right for you at this moment of time. You scroll through the pages and this particular page stops by with lots of information there. Hold it up. Look into that page. Look into the information. Sometimes it could be cryptic, or it's just the symbols, or sometimes the page could be blank. That's perfectly fine. Look into the energy of the page. Ask your guides, is there any other information they would like to share in the way that you would be able to receive right now? Through the pictures, through a movie, or a past life instance, or a word, or a symbol? Let that information come in. And do notice how is your heart feeling, how is your body reacting being in that place with the records book. And breathe out. Asking the guides, the masters, to show you something that is very relevant to you right now. And you can visit this place anytime you wish to. Knowing that the information is going to flow later through your dreams, through as you're reading or you're channeling in your meditations. You close the book, hold it to your heart, feel the connection. Now, placing the book back in the shelf, knowing that you can come back here anytime you wish to, and this place is always open for you. You're coming back out of that beautiful library, back into the crystal cave area. Thanking the masters, loved ones, angels, the guides, everyone that has been there to support you. And breathing all that energy into your soul. Coming out of the cave, back with your guardian angels, walking down the rainforest. Now feeling much lighter, gaining so much of information, looking into the life in a different perspective, jumping and dancing along, walking back, and to the count of 10 to 1, coming back into this room, into your 10, 9, 8. Gently wiggling your toes. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3. Gently moving your shoulders, your arms, your elbows. Three, two, one. You can open your eyes. If you have a journal handy, write your thoughts, write your experiences down, write your messages down. And have some sip of water. Do notice how your physical body is feeling. It's been on a journey to a different dimension. And you can feel a bit lightheaded or tired as well. So do look after yourself. If you want to be in that comfortable place, that's perfectly fine. All right, whenever you're ready, please share your experience. Interesting to see what you have got. Todd is asking, if I'm not Christian, how do archangels apply? I'm not Christian as well. Angels are there for every one of us. If you look into the thought about there is some being that is looking after us, minding us and keeping us safe, and that is the energy we can build in. Yeah. And in case you don't have anything, for us, we all believe there is a source connection, right? We can even apply the same energy there. Jay, feeling much better hearing you with monkey mind. Definitely, yeah. It's like when we shift from the third dimension to the fifth dimension, the mind gets relaxed, and that's the whole thing about the Akashic realm. What it does is, like, no matter how much pressure we have, we just feel like more within ourselves. And that's my favorite place to go into a meditation. It does so much of a deep healing as well. Okay, thank you. I feel like I have been on a journey. I don't know what happened. I was in a cave and then I woke up and we were closing the book. That's perfectly fine, Joshua. Your mind, subconscious mind, is taking the note of it. So that's perfectly fine, yeah. Bettina, difficult to visualize, but felt the presence of someone on my left side. That's beautiful to feel the presence of it. And you can always go back to it. And I have a couple of recordings of a meditation itself. You can visit my profile and you can try those meditations as well. And sometimes for some people, it's harder the first time. It's just because we are going into a different realm, not knowing what to expect as well. And sometimes the magic has happened that we haven't taken a note of it. But definitely go and visit it again. Yeah. Will you be doing this again? Yes, I'm planning to doing more of it. Next week, I have on Thursday, connecting to your angels topic. And something in the following week, I'll arrange something about Akashic as well. I felt I wasn't getting much. It felt like I had to use my imagination. What's weird is I became very sad. I ended up in tears. Amy, that's perfectly fine. We do have to use a bit of imagination. The messages, they come, we feel they are what we think, but it's not what we think. It's subtle way they do come up. The egoistic mind will be loud and very much of I, you kind of a thing. But when it's Akashic messages, they are very gentle, loving, caring. And the tears are not about a thing that we are holding up. Sometimes it's about joyful tears as well. And some emotions that has to be released. And that physically it's being done. As said, like, you know, going into the meditation, this can bring us a lot of clearance, a shift on our physical self as well. So that is what has happened. I felt like I need more love. That's it. Yeah, we all need the love. And just hug yourself and say, I love myself. And that's the best way to begin in, right? Who else can we love more than ourselves? Vanessa, thank you. I saw two visuals, not sure what they mean, but grateful for this experience and guidance. Thank you so much for sharing all that. Yeah, let it all sink in. Like, you know, it does take a little bit of a process and a time as well, because you have been on a journey. If you have never been onto this, it's the first time that's coming up as well. So there is a lot to process. So purple and red gems, the book was very heavy in my hand. Sometimes yes, sometimes I get only scrolls. So whatever method they chose, that's fine. And sometimes I get to see only through movie kind of a clipping or a PowerPoint kind of a clipping. So be very open to the way that you would be resonating with. As some of my students do see as like only past life instances, or sometimes I'm being shown as like a more sci-fi thing. It's all different to the energy that we are operating on. Yeah, I need to be more conscious. It's just setting your intentions is more important, Joshua, that you want to be here to see, receive that's right for your soul. Yeah, and with that intention, it's much easier. So the way it works is like, you know, generally having that intention, like we can go into the records every day and access it, get the information, but doesn't apply or connect to us in any other ways. But if you go with a particular question, it helps on to connecting to a solution in that proper channeled way. Say I'm going into the records with nothing to expect. I'm just enjoying that meditation. I'm just feeling the cleanse and the relaxation. That's it. I come out of it perfectly fine. But if I go into the records asking a question, what is that I need to write my second book about? And so when I get that book, I open it up and see the message. I'm taking that information related to my book. And when I come out of this consciousness into my body, then I can implement that in a practical way as well. And that is so important, you know, to have a question. Definitely I always ask my clients to bring in the questions, so we can go into a proper channel and get the best out of it, and you will see reflection of that to be much more stronger rather than being vague. Like, yeah, that definitely helps as well. And when you're totally, like, you know, consciously awake, it might take a few more minutes for you guys to come out of it. Ground yourself, drink more water or herbal tea, I would highly recommend. And see how you're processing as well. Mind will be so calm, right? And that will help us to be clearing a lot of stuff as well, like some limiting beliefs will be cleared, or some validations will come in as well that you were doubting about it. Shift in the thoughts or ideas will come in that you are holding on to more strongly. So yeah, any other questions? This is lovely to connect with you all. And would you like to see more topic on this? Because I'm really enjoying this. Yes. And yeah, there is a donation button if you're happy with what you have received. I'll be very grateful for that, so I can continue this work to be offering more of a free service here on the Insight Timer. And thanks for your time as well to be here. Like, and do definitely do check on my profile on Insight Timer and see the events that are coming up, or you can follow me so you know you're getting notified on the next events that I'm going to place up. And with Akashic Records, the other interesting things are about, like, who are our soulmates? What is our purpose with them as well? Why do we have a turmoil at the location thing? Like, you know, one of the clients, this is an interesting one. The client came in asking that I want to sell this place, but I'm having a difficulty selling my farmland. And what can I do about it? So when I opened the records, this person's farmland was in a weird shape. It's like a hexagon or something. It's not like a square or a triangle that I would generally see in the farmlands. I went in, I drew it on my piece of paper, and for that he needed to do some land healing, and by that he'll be releasing it, saying thanks to the land, and he'll be able to sell it. And when I said that, he brought in his blueprint of his land papers as well, and he showed me they were exactly the same as what I drew up on the paper. So that was really interesting to see, like, you know, things, how they get channeled is that connection and being open to receiving it in the right guidance. And after a couple of months, he did message me that he was able to sell the land and move to London to do some of the work. Yeah, it just lifted a burden for him. So clearing to the land, he wouldn't have thought about it without the guidance of Akashic realms. Like, you know, it's just like praying and being grateful for the land and thank you for releasing it. So that was very interesting. Like, you know, I would never do that. But now I would think about the options of it, like, you know. So that's really interesting as well. Yeah, some of the things that come up as a solutions are simple and also so deep as well. So any other insights? If not, we can wrap up. So hope you enjoyed that healing through the Akashic Records. So thank you so much for being here and listening to and being part of the meditation. So we'll see you again next time. Thank you so much, guys. Namaste. Have a wonderful day or evening. Thank you.